Nobody likes dealing with VoIP issues, from choppy voices to dropped calls, delays, and routing messages. Nothing gets in the way of business faster than an unreliable VoIP connection. In this video, we're gonna give you 5 ways to troubleshoot so that you can get your team back gabbing at full speed. Since most issues that affect call quality derive from the network, let's start by performing some routine troubleshooting there. Like all computer issues, the best place to start is with a restart. First, shut down all the computers on your network. Next, locate any switches and your router. We want to restart any devices that stand between your voice and the internet. Common troubleshooting wisdom says to leave your devices unplugged for 30 seconds before you plug them back in. That seems kind of sadistic. It's kind of like the digital equivalent of holding someone's head underwater for another minute after they stop. I'm gonna think of another analogy and get back to you on that one. Let's just keep troubleshooting. Next, let's log into your router and disable all of the SIP helpers, especially SIP ALG. Now, these features attempted to fix VoIP issues, but they tend to cause more issues than they fix, and they don't really help the majority of business use cases anyway. However, if you are dropping calls at 10 to 11 minutes consistently, SIP ALG might be the cause. While you're in the router, check if VoIP Quality of Service, or QoS, is enabled. If your router doesn't have VoIP QoS, it might be time for an upgrade. QoS is a feature that allows the router to reserve a certain amount of bandwidth for your VoIP calls to ensure quality. If your router doesn't have VoIP QoS, you might be able to log in and dedicate a certain amount of bandwidth to your VoIP devices by finding their MAC addresses and assigning a minimum bandwidth for each device. And you'll probably want to set that at about 100 kbps. Now, if reconfiguring your router doesn't solve your issues, it's time for an upgrade. New modern routers not only include VoIP QoS support, but they're also often dual band. Now, that allows you to segregate traffic from smart appliances like thermostats and everything else in your digital life to a slower network, while you keep the computers, TVs, and VoIP phones chugging along on the faster network. All right, now that we've sorted out the network, let's take a look at some call quality issues in more detail and how to address them. We're talking specifically about echo, delays, distortion, and buzzing. Most of these issues are caused by electronic interference or faulty equipment. Now, if you're experiencing an echo or buzzing, you might want to cut back on the caffeine or try covering your phone's microphone. If you cover the phone's microphone and the audio goes back to normal, you may just need to turn the audio level down on your speakers or earpiece. Try moving your router away from other equipment if possible. Fans, monitors, and power strips can sometimes cause enough interference to affect call quality. You'll also want to try removing any equipment that sits between your router and the VoIP device, like caller ID boxes or switches. Now, this one might hurt a little bit if this is the culprit. Check your wires. Make sure that everything is plugged in where it's supposed to be and you don't have this going on. A dog would never do that. Finally, you might just want to look into some new equipment. Headsets and speakers can degrade over time, leading to distortion and other call quality issues. All right, once you've checked off all the easy stuff on the list, it's time to take a look at your wide area network, connectivity, and internet provider. Not all ISPs support VoIP on all plans, so make sure that yours does while we check the following. Start by running a bandwidth test. Nextiva has a great one that allows you to specify the number of VoIP lines, and you can find a link to it in the description below. Next, test for packet loss. Damaged wiring or faulty ISP network equipment might cause some of your packets to wander off. To chase them down, you can run a ping test with a network monitoring tool. A ping test will deliver a series of pings to a remote server and report back on the percentage lost. It's also the only test that you want to get a zero on, with the exception of certain medical tests. Finally, if none of that helps, but you're still shooting your ISP the side eye, give them a call and make sure that your issues aren't related to service plan limitations or network outages. While you're sorting out call quality issues, it's probably also a good time for a security audit. Compromised VoIP accounts or compromised security in general can allow hackers to utilize your bandwidth, degrading call quality and putting your data at risk. It's a good practice to reset your VoIP account and admin passwords regularly. Deploy a firewall and limit the type of traffic sent and received on your VoIP-enabled devices. Don't let hackers hurt your brand by doing things that you wouldn't approve of with your phone number, like calling my grandma and saying you're the bank credentials inspector. Knock it off, lad. Stay the hell away from Nana. Now, if you're still having trouble after going through all of the issues above, be sure to call your VoIP provider. They should be able to provide tech support and to help you identify any issues related to the VoIP service itself. Nextiva has solutions to all of your business communication needs, including VoIP, so if you're not getting amazing service at your current provider, it might be a good time to consider a change. Thanks again for watching. I'm Jake with Nextiva. We'll see you next time.